like it? And how did everyone look? Are we stealing stuff from it? Is it problematic? It's brunch movie reviews.
Black Panther, a superhero movie that was nominated for Best Picture.
Weird.
Kind of weird, kind of crazy, but you know what? I am not a superhero movie guy. I always say that when I watch a superhero movie, I am how you say a dog in front of a TV, which is I'm just like sitting there smiling, looking around like, I don't understand any of this.
Just enjoying the visuals.
Right, like this, like... That person can jump a lot better than I can jump, and right. Everybody, but I look around and everyone's like, so
you're just there for the visuals and the aura of excitement.
And happy for everybody. I saw Black Panther with a friend who was like really into superhero movies, and after he was like, that was good, right? And I was like, you know what? Yeah, it was. And he was like, are you going to see blah, 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 blah? And I was like, don't know what any of those things are. Just like Michael B. Jordan, pal. See you later. Let's jump into it. Did we like it out of 4?
3.1 out of 4 for me. I thought that it was very, very fun.
Yeah, I gave it a 3, which is, again, it might sound, because that's like a 75 out of 100. But, I mean, I'd be lying if I say that I usually feel better than that when watching a superhero movie. Like, I really liked the new Spider-Man one. Right. I liked the Spider-Man one with the kids. But I liked those, at least the one with the kids, the Homecoming one. I liked that in probably like a 6 out of 10, which is crazy,
yeah.
Kind of way. Liked the story. Easy to follow along, which is a huge thing for me with superhero movies, because when I watch a superhero movie, I'm like a dog in front of a TV where I just don't understand what I'm seeing.
Callback.
A little callback humor. Yes.
I thought it was, the villains were great. Loved Claw, loved Killmonger, Michael B. Jordan.
I had a tough time with Daniel Kaluuya being a bit of a double crosser.
Right.
That
was like kind of like,
I was a little
over.
Upset with that. So, because it was like really at the time of like, hey, how much do we all love Daniel Kaluuya?
That's right.
I don't know, more than anything. Hey, he's kind of a dick.
Tough back-to-back project.
Yeah.
In terms of like juxtaposition. But yeah, I thought it was very fun, very smart. Like it offered like very smart depth. Like it had depth. There was like political commentary. There were like societal commentary.
It felt like you were watching a movie versus watching a superhero movie at all times, which
was
cool.
And so like, and obviously the cultural impact of this movie was massive.
Yeah.
And I think that that's a big part of the reason why they were willing to include it in the Best Picture conversation. And I like that. And obviously it has a big impact. Ultimately, though, like I don't know if this is a hot take or anything, but like I think that Black Panther might have been like the third best superhero movie of 2018.
Because the
Spider-Verse.
Yeah.
And it might be like a 2A and 2B situation, but like Infinity War was unbelievable.
Ah.
The Avengers movie.
Okay. I was like,
there you go, dog in front of a TV.
Sounds like a thing.
Dumbass.
I thought you were going to say, what's the one with bootleg Tom Hardy?
Upgrade.
But that's not a superhero?
Not really a superhero movie.
That's like a, it's like a robot movie.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, yeah. So, like, I get it, but it's not my best picture.
I like that there are. People get mad that too many movies are nominated for Best Picture these days because now there's like 41 of them nominated a year. But I do think it's cool that if a horror movie is really, really good, like Get Out was, then it can be nominated.
I don't think we should be automatically excluding certain genres or categories.
Exactly. Like this. So like this was not one of my 5 favorite movies of the year. Really not by a long shot. I mean, we saw so many movies and so many movies that we liked. I just saw Cold War, which also makes the list of, man, this really should have been nominated instead of some bullshit like Bohemian Rhapsody. But what are you going to do? But this is like, this to me is a movie where I'm happy it's nominated because A, like you said, it's outside of the box to get a superhero movie nominated. It was just like a massive, like culturally, everybody liked it. Everybody saw it.
I think you're wrong. There's a lot of people who like didn't really love
Black Panther. Did they think it strayed too much from being a superhero movie?
I'm not sure
why. Because maybe that's why I liked it.
I'm not sure what the reason is, but like there are a lot of people who don't feel too strongly about
it. But I know that like this happened with Kacey Musgraves winning Album of the Year at the Grammys. A lot of people were like, hey, I don't listen to country, so I didn't hear that album. Why is it being nominated if everyone hasn't heard it? And that's really not what these things are about, but I do understand that if you're like a casual movie watcher or casual music listener, when you're watching an award show, you do want to see something you've seen, something that, again, everyone's seen be represented. And this is a case of that happening while it also being a really good movie. Right. So I'm glad it was nominated again. Probably wouldn't make my top 10, but glad it's nominated. I gave it a 3 out of 4 for that. So we're kind of on the same page there. Here's an interesting one. How did everyone look? I gave it a 1.5 out of 2 because Michael B. Jordan always looks good. Tell you what, though, a little bumpy for my liking.
Ah, it's like his like branding.
He
or
had the, what's it called? What are those, what's that thing called that everyone gets now?
Aren't they like brands?
Yes, but it's but it looked like, what's the, it's like a type of...
It looks scaly, sort
of. It's like a type of like muscle therapy thing that people get.
Cupping?
Yeah, it looks like he was cupping a bit.
Yes, with like the thinnest things. And I guess each one of those marks symbolized somebody that he killed.
Right, so he killed like...
A lot of people. He was a killing machine in the military.
Oh, right. Yeah.
That's why he got the nickname Killmonger.
Well...
I thought that he looked very, very cool. Like, yeah. His fashion and his hair.
Right,
and
his
like
hair
the glasses,
was...
unbelievable. Wow. Like, such a great look for Michael B. Jordan.
Chadwick looking good as usual.
Yeah, always. I thought the wardrobe choices were unbelievable.
Yeah.
It was very, very cool. Lupita, I can't say
Lupita,
her last name. Nyong'o?
Nyong'o?
Something like that. She's gorgeous.
Oh, yeah.
Love her. The wardrobe was great. I'm deducting a few points. I'm going to give it a 1.7 because I thought that the CGI was kind of iffy at points.
Really?
Yeah. I don't know if that's, I don't know if I'm wrong there, but for me, it kind of just like took me out of it just a little bit.
Well,
the CGI.
Remember with the Spider-Man, with the Spider-Verse movie, that was a big point of contention for us where a lot of like the animation sometimes looked like you couldn't tell quite what you were watching.
I was in a between 2D and 3D
right,
experience.
Yeah, exactly. I'm trying to remember if when I saw Black Panther, it... I saw it on opening night, not to brag, so it was so long ago. But I can't remember if I saw it in 3D or 2D, but I did not have that takeaway. Okay.
I watched it recently, so I still had the same feeling.
It is on Netflix. I'd like to rewatch it.
So 1.7 for me.
1.5 for me. Are we stealing stuff from it? Again, we're kind of looking back on a lot of these things, so whether or not we're stealing stuff from it, people did take lines from it. Like, Wakanda Forever was a huge thing. Throwing up, like, the symbol and everything was a huge thing. And This Your King was a huge thing. So, what should I give that?
I'm giving it a 1.5. Those two things, Wakanda Forever, Is This Your King, and then the soundtrack as well.
Oh, God! Yeah. I forgot. Oh, God. So, I don't know why I blanked on that. I'm bumping that up all the way to 2 then because that soundtrack was probably one of the 10 best albums to come out last year. King is Dead by J-Rock, amazing. All the Stars, really, like all the songs on that soundtrack were
It was nominated
really,
for
really
album
good.
Of the year.
And it should have been.
Yeah, right.
Like,
so.
If something that I thought was like top 10 gets nominated for a top 5 thing, I'm happy because there's always going to be something on there that you're like, oh God, how'd you do this? And plus, I know that they're just from year to year, they are not going to nominate Father John Misty for Album of the Year. So I was very happy that was nominated. That was actually on my, so I wanted Golden Hour by Kacey Musgraves to win or Dirty Computer by Janelle Monáe. But then there's always a couple that you're like, I want others to win more than this, but I'd be okay with this winning. Black Panther soundtrack was like at the top of that part of the list. So I'll bump that all the way up to 2. Thank you for reminding me of that.
You
also
bet,
shouts out Ludwig Göransson, who scored the film. He had an interesting night at the Grammys when he went up and everybody saw that This Is America was written by a Swedish guy. hilarious. People were quite confused. They were like, what's this dude with long hair going up there to get the This Is America Grammy for? So I'll bump that up to 2. Thank you very much for that reminder. Is it problematic out of 2? Again, if depending on whether or not you want stuff to be, like if it's a horror movie and you want some like weird stuff and there is some weird stuff, you give it a high score. And if it's a movie that's not supposed to be problematic and it's not problematic, you give it a high score. I don't remember anything problematic about this movie, so I'll give it a nice 1.8. How about you?
Why 1.8 if you can't remember anything?
Because maybe there was and I forgot.
Okay, that's a fair point. Maybe I'll do the same thing then. I'm going to give it a 1.9. I'm going to... Is it my Price is Righting you or is Price is Right the opposite?
Yeah, no. Price is Righting is going one higher. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm
going
to Price is Right you with 1.9 just to give myself a little bit of wiggle room. So that gives me... Are we doing final score now?
Yeah. Okay. This gets a super high score for me. So 4.5, 6.5. Yeah, this gets an 8.3 from me, which I assumed it would probably be in the mid to high sevens. But man, that soundtrack is no joke. So it gets all the credit in the world. 8.3.
You ended up with an 8.3. I have an 8.3 as well.
Really?
Yes.
I thought you said 8.2. Did you...
I did the math wrong, I believe.
Shouts out to you. All right. 8.3s all the way around. Black Panther.